I'm 58 years old, so as I was growing up in the 60s, my teens, the Beatles was very much an important part of my life. I remember their songs vividly, Let It Be, Money Can't Buy Me Love, and of course, one of my all-time favorites was actually one by George Harrison, My Sweet Lord, I think, which is one of the most wonderful songs ever written.
So what's the experience like of actually being here at the ashram?
Yeah, it's a unique experience. It took us a while. We walked for about 2 kilometers to find it. And as we walked in, the experience was quite surreal, because to think that in the 60s, these really super famous musicians had actually come all the way here. And they must have lived in some of the quarters now, which are dilapidated or have been abandoned. So to think that they came here 50 years ago to this place, and what was it that captivated them to come here? So those were the thoughts which were going through my mind as I walked through the exhibition. And of course, I've seen, the exhibition's very interesting. Of course, there's one part about the Beatles exhibition, and then you've got the other part on the Transcendental Meditation, which is equally interesting. And I've, of course, seen pictures of the Beatles here with Mia Farrow and Donovan and even some of the members of the Beach Boys. So it's just bringing back all those memories, adding to what I'd already seen in previous documentaries. So it's well worth the 1 hour walk to get here.
Would you recommend this to your friends?
I would, if they have an interest in the Beatles and, just to come and see what this place looked like. That there was a setup in the 60s which attracted the biggest names in the world at that time. I think it's something which shouldn't be missed. It's fabulous.